this is Canada, huh?
These woods are totally awesome. This actually looks like a place where an actual Bigfoot would actually hang out. This is gonna be perfect.
The hell?
Yeah, what was that, Roy?
All right, relax, tough guys. This is the woods. You know, there's birds and there's rabbits and donkeys and stuff that live here.
If any wild animals come anywhere near me, I swear, I'm gonna super kick their heads in. Good old-fashioned gunpowder barrel explosion. You hear me?
All right. Enough already, you pansies. Now let's unload the gear. Let's make ourselves a $50,000 prize-winning film.
Bang.
Farther, guys, and I think we'll find a clearing that we can shoot in.
Hey, why can't we shoot it here, Roy? I mean, woods is woods. This all looks the same.
AJ, my simple-minded friend, I'm an artist. And furthermore, I'm a perfectionist. I'll admit that. I have a perfect vision of perfection in my mind, and this spot is not the perfect spot I see in my perfect vision. All right, this spot just isn't it, okay?
Well, you could carry some equipment, Roy.
Listen, I need to conserve my energy for directing, okay?
Whatever.
What the hell is this?
That's the extra gasoline I siphoned for the car.
You jerk! People drink from canteens. When one sees a canteen in a camping-like setting like this, they can only speculate that it's full of refreshing water. Not gasoline!
Look, I'm sorry.
I'm seriously mad at you right now, AJ!
Said I was sorry.
Hey, come on, guys. We'll be there soon. Let's just hang in there. Let's get this done, and then we'll get out of here that much sooner, okay? Now, I want to see the two of you shake hands and apologize to one another.
Okay. I'm sorry. I should have asked before I drank from your canteen. And it's not totally unheard of that someone might keep automobile fuel inside of a canteen. I'm sorry.
And I'm sorry that you had to drink gasoline again. Now let's make up with our electricity lord's secret handshake.
We're burning daylight! Let's move them out, we're still 15 clicks outside the net!
This is it.
This is where the magic's gonna happen. Okay, AJ. You're in charge of wrangling Ronnie. I'm gonna need him to start over there by the edge of the clearing and run back and forth across a couple times.
No problem.
Ronnie? Ronnie, buddy? Walk over here.
I'm walking over there. Super Mario Brothers.
All right, places, everyone. And action! Cue Ronnie!
Oh my God, it's a Bigfoot! I am so surprised and also scared!
Would you guys mind not screwing around so I can get my shot before we lose all of our light? Is that the best you can do, numbnuts?
Knock it off, Roy. Leave him alone.
I'm gonna kick your ass.
Oh, you're gonna kick my ass. Real funny, Kevin. With what? Your bad comedy?
Quando grande sei io, dipinsi una pintura.
Son of a bitch. I'm gonna kill you!
Quando grande sei io, dipinsi una pintura.
like being face to face with the Sasquatch?
Well, I was scared at first. The beast had these 6-inch drooling fangs, and it was carrying a baseball bat with spikes driven through it, like as some kind of primitive club. Tragically, it ate all my friends, and I barely escaped with my life and a few cans of soda.
Oh dear. It actually ate your friends?
Yeah, it ate their faces off, like they were made of Butterfingers and Skittles. I'm really lucky to be alive, let alone the sole winner of $50,000. Suckers.
What was that?
I said suckers.
Joining the program is Dr. Jason Football, world-famous cryptozoologist and author of the New York Times bestseller, I, Skeptic. Thank you for joining us, Dr. Football.
My pleasure to be here. Sage, thanks for having me.
As an expert in the field of Sasquatch sightings and advanced science, what's your take on this amazing Bigfoot footage?
Well, Sage, in my professional opinion, this footage is a blatant forgery and an out-and-out fake, and a badly done hoax at that. The Sasquatch is obviously a man in a gorilla suit, and the shoddy footage is definitely a dirly.
Those are some harsh accusations, Dr. Football. What's your reaction to these allegations, Roy?
Well, my reaction is that Dr. Jason Football can eat it big time.
Now, hold on a minute! I demand respect! I am a scientist!
Yeah, a scientist of not getting laid.
How dare you speak to me that way? I am an expert on Sasquatches, and your footage disgusts me!
Why don't you just admit that my awesome footage rocks your world?
Why don't you admit that your footage is a fake?
I'll admit I have some naked pictures of your mom.
I hate all of you!
I am the greatest man of all times.
Thanks for stopping.
No problem. Where are you headed?
America. I've got an old friend to visit. With a vengeance.
Hey, Ronnie!
Who are you?
It's a Luigi!
Luigi?
That's right. Ronnie, will you dance and prance and sing with me? Will you go frolic with glee, whistling a merry tune? Then perhaps later, I'll breast to feed you some delicious cola.
I want to dance with Luigi.
Okay.
Look like you have the blues. Why so glum?
Nobody thinks I'm funny. Also, I saw a Bigfoot a little while ago and it scared me.
Oh. Hey, why don't you try out some of your jokes on me? I'll give you a totally honest, subjective opinion.
No, I couldn't. It's just too awkward.
Oh, come on. I could use a good laugh.
Okay. Alright, okay. Helen Keller's phone rings.
Okay.
But because she's blind, she accidentally shoots herself with a gun. Well, my so-called friends don't think so.
Well, then your friends must not love you. Kevin, what if I was to tell you that I could offer you all the friends you would ever want, and all of them would think you were funny? It'd be like a family where you'd be accepted and praised, and you could also experience spiritual enlightenment.
You're talking about church, right? I already attend a family church, and the church doesn't think I'm funny. My pastor slapped me in the face once, hard.
But Kevin, I'm talking about the Church of Satan.
The Church of Satan?
Yes, Kevin, the Church of Satan. Now I know what you're thinking, and admittedly we have gotten a bad rep in the media over the last millennium or so, but we've made a lot of changes over the years too. It's not this group of people in black cloaks sacrificing virgins that you might think. Our new dress code is strictly business casual, and we only sacrifice stray dogs. And even that we only do every so often. And you get to taste real baby at our annual Feast of the Damned, not to mention all the super hot orgies in pig's blood. So what do you say, Kevin? Your new family in Lucifer is just waiting to welcome you with open arms.
Oh, wow, look at that over there. But we're already at my house.
But we're still in Canada.
No, thank
you. Be safe.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye.
Jedi! Solo thought you might get Jaya. Kasuyari
Korato Kamawan. Excuse me, did one of you just say Unabomber again?
Oh, dear God, why are you facing me? Oh, God, no! God bless my burning eyes! Please stop facing me! Looks like you're out of mace, huh? The Canadian Gaylords are out of mace! I was just kidding. You're not Gaylords. There's no need to continue with the macing.
I was just about to give you a call and see if you wanted to go out for breakfast, and then we could rent movies.
Come here! You can't!
This Bigfoot footage is tearing us apart. We're family. Blood brothers. We need to stick together. Not fight. Love. Not hate.
Fading fast.
let me get this straight. You spent all $50,000 in 2 days. On what?
Well, fireworks mostly. Candy, lots of candy. I got this huge burlap sack full of Jolly Ranchers and one of those forklift pallets full of those now and laters. Stopped eating regular eggs and only ate Cadbury eggs. I got this fur coat. It's pretty sweet. It's made out of baby panda bears and bald eagles. I got plastic surgery on my ass. I ate lots of steaks and caviar and lobster and steaks. Did I mention steaks? Yeah, juicy, succulent steaks. I took baths in expensive champagne with Siamese twin exotic dancers. And I washed their bodies with a special soap made out of diamonds. And then humping. I got mugged twice. Serves me right for carrying gold bars in my book bag. You know, it's bound to happen. You know, $50,000 really isn't that much money.
Take it easy, Kevin.
It just burns me up a little, Roy, that you gave away my car to a homeless man.
Kevin, to you it was just a car. But to that homeless man, it was a car and a home and a private bathroom. Besides, I was gonna buy you a sweet-ass DeLorean to replace it. And a dune buggy.
Really? A DeLorean?
Swear to God, man.
Wow. Thanks for thinking of me, Roy. I guess if anyone owes someone an apology, I owe you one. I'm sorry.
I accept your apology, Kevin. But what I want to know is how AJ escaped from those Mounties.
Yeah, AJ. How did you escape from Canada?
I had to kill those Mounties. Lethal karate punch. Drive their nose bones straight up into their brains. Killing them instantly.
Well, I think we learned an important lesson this weekend, fellas.
And what's that, Roy?
Bigfoots are real.
Amen, brother.
How hard do you think it would be to build a fake UFO?
Here we go again!